Hi, it's me again. I'm currently in Melbourne, in the city of Melbourne, and a lot of tourists come here and they look at the sights. But I'm going to look for movie locations, places where movies were shot, and a lot of movies have been shot here in Melbourne over the years. I'm going to search for them. Okay, that's it. Let's get started.
With my trusty World Film Location book, I discovered a few little gems that were shot around here. Like Graham Blundell coming in for a landing in a very different looking Melbourne in 1973's Alvin Purple. In 1975 saw the release of a movie called
Can I Help You Fellas?
Four young heroin addicts go in search of some good quality narcotics. In one scene, they knock off a chemist on Elizabeth Street.
You split the head open and take the stuff, well, you take it anyway. Help yourself.
The gate next to the chemist the men jump over is still there. Across the Yarra River is a location of a very unusual Australian film.
Okay, join me up there.
The pirate movie from 1982 opens at the Polly Woodside ship that's permanently docked in South Wharf. This interesting 1980s time capsule stars Kristen McNichol and that guy from the Blue Lagoon.
In and out. Huh?
Yeah! She'll do it!
Do you think if she took off her glasses, she'd go from that introverted girl to the love of a man? Surely not, no. Oh, this is where the exhibition centre is now. Or Jeff Shedd. In 1970, Tony Richardson gave us his version of Ned Kelly. Rock star Mick Jagger gave us his portrayal of the real-life bushranger. Police persecution leads Kelly into a life of crime before getting caught and then hanged in Old Melbourne Jail. The execution scene was shot in the exact same spot where Ned Kelly himself was hanged 90 years earlier.
This is how they shall remember me. My mother that reared me. My family. My friends. Not broken, not bedraggled, not condemned.
No prisoners!
Mind you die like a Kelly, son.
Such is life.
Dogs in Space was released in 1986, which is basically about people doing drugs and trashing a house. The film opens in a small street in Richmond where most of the film will take place.
Three, two, one.
Ladies and gentlemen, the stories you are about to hear are true. Only the names have been changed to protect the innocent.
And now, live across Australia, welcome to Countdown with a look at David Bowie fever.
I want to say that I've just seen David Bowie concert in Melbourne at the MCG.
Thunderbirds are go.
Boys next door, do you want to hear more?
Dogs in Space takes us into the world of drugs and alcohol, showing us party givers mindlessly driving around the streets at night, or sitting in front of the TV searching for meaning in the TV test pattern, before setting the TV on fire, in the middle of the street.
Oh, sorry.
See ya, Buster.
Have you seen
the kite? Not another one. This film is a great example of gritty Melbourne filmmaking, which has a timelessness and contemporary feel that keeps us relevant in today's world, even though it's set in 1978. But like most things, that's debatable. Danny is a teenage boy in love with Jaguar cars and Joanna. Danny wants to go on a date with Joanna, but his father has given him a 1963 Nissan Cedric, which is way too embarrassing a car to take a girl on a date with. Danny wants to trade the Cedric and meet sleazy used car salesman
Gordon Fox.
He uses every dirty trick to sell a Jag to Danny and swaps the engine right before purchase for a dud. Anybody remember this film? What was it called?
The building behind me is formerly known as Collingwood Technical School. And it's the school that Danny Clark goes to in the film The Big Steal. All those scenes in the beginning of the film were shot in there. Collingwood Technical School in Collingwood. There is one shot of Danny and his friends coming out of the entrance to the school, which is actually here, the South Melbourne Technical School in Albert Park. Different location, same school. I don't know. One of those strange movie things, but there it is. Now it's the sports house. Now we've got to find Danny's house in, I think Footscray. Somewhere that way. Oh, let's find Danny's house. Big Steal was filmed in November and December of 1989. It was released in 1990. It was directed by Nadia Tass and written by David Parker. It stars Ben Mendelsohn.
Really? Man of your talents?
That wasn't The Big Steal. Okay. Claudia Carvin. Steve Bisley, who's great in this film, as Gordon Farkas.
Don't I know you?
And a bunch of other people who I've never seen in a film ever again, who are really good. They're really good in this movie. And this is the house that Danny lives in. And apparently, according to the DVD commentary, David Parker says that they actually extended the fence line further out for the film, so they'd have room to move here. So a lot of action in the film takes place in this very spot where I'm standing.
Haven't you forgotten something? Daniel's birthday.
Would that be Daniel the Lion Tamer? Or Daniel our son?
Daniel our son.
The part where Danny's father goes nuts because he finds out his son sold the Cedric. I think he's standing about here. Right here. Danny wants to go on a date with Joanna, and he tells her that he's got a Jaguar. But Joanna doesn't really care about cars. She even tells him that, and also that that it's not even a draw card for her, a Jag. But she's going on a date with him anyway, so he's told her he's got a Jag, so now he's got to buy a Jaguar.
You looking or dreaming?
So the car yard is here.
Yes.
This is a carpet shop. What happened?
This is a carpet shop.
Have you seen the movie The Big Steal? It's an
years
Aussie
ago.
Movie. Yeah,
years
well, the
ago.
Car yard where he buys the car is somewhere here. Yeah, so that was a petrol station over there. They've taken it out, replaced it with units, of course. Yeah, you can see those two houses in the film, but that house has put a second story on there. So the guys are checking out the car somewhere there, but it's an art shop as well. So a carpet shop and an art shop has replaced Jeff Mullen Motors. Oh, we don't even know if it was actually a car yard. In fact, when they were making the film, people were coming in and making offers to buy the cars that were there because they thought it was a real car yard. South Melbourne has completely changed since The Big Steal was made. The scene where Danny's Jag breaks down and oil gets spitted all over Jaina is in a street that's here, but no longer here.
Little boys in big cars. You're all the bloody same.
You can see that building off in the distance. But now there's a casino in the place of where that scene was shot. That's in the film. It's where Danny works with his friends at night. And we get a scene with Gordon Farkas, how he comes to the car park and the guys have got to swap the engines. He's given Danny a Jag with a bad engine, so he's done it dirty on him. So let's go into the car park and see if it's changed. Okay. There's a lot of shots looking that way. Some of it's changed, but it's mostly the same. Gordon drives in here. They did this up in the film. This is like an office. Maybe for the film they built the office, because there's nothing here. Maybe there was an office here in 1990. 89 it was actually shot, but over here, this wasn't here, it's a convenience store. There's more car park behind Gordon Farkas. When you see him, when he comes back early, he says, "Where's my car?"
Pardon?
Where's my car?
Big steal. Awesome. So they get to work on Gordon's car. Around here, I think. I better check the film. Not 100% sure where the little workshop was where they swapped the engines in the Jag, but it's could have been here. Over there. Could have been anywhere. Doesn't matter, we're in the car park. That was the car park in the Big Steel.
The boys switch the engine while Gordon goes off gallivanting around strip clubs getting drunk. He later picks up the car with its original bad engine. And this shot has Gordon driving down St. Kilda Road, attracting the attention of the police. Now, here Gordon is on St. Kilda Road in the middle of the city heading south, and suddenly pulled over in St. Kilda 6.5 kilometres away, right next to Luna Park. These strange things do happen in films. The Big Steel is a great coming-of-age film littered with funny one-liners and a likeable protagonist to cheer on against a delightful villain in Gordon Farkas.
Amazing how that works. Well, that's it. Those are the movie locations for this video. Hope you enjoyed them. And I had a few more movie locations to go to, but it's kind of illegal now to go somewhere where, unless you're shopping for food or going to the bank, maybe the banks are open, I don't know. Essential services only. I don't think that includes YouTube videos. There is a coronavirus going around. It's pretty serious, pretty terrible. And so most of us are staying inside. Like me. Looking outside to see the bare streets. So just gonna have to stay inside. And watch movies. Watch The Big Steel if you haven't seen it. I didn't give away the ending, which is quite a very funny ending. And go to the supermarket. My supermarket looks like this. Plenty of empty shelves, but that's going on everywhere in the world. And I'm just going to wrap it up. I hope you enjoyed the video. And see you next time. Yes, there will be a next time.